Erin, I've got somebody who'd like to speak to you who was listening to that. It's only Justin of the Darkness, everybody!
OMG!
Hey, Erin, how's it going? Well, I thought that sounded beautiful, and you've inspired
me.
I think I'm gonna shave an undercut into my hair today. I think you were right.
Oh, Erin, what a treat. You get to speak to your hero yourself. Keep up with the amazing work on the guitar, by the way. And we're so glad we finally got
to hear that.
Have you got a question for Justin and Dan and Rufus from the Darkness?
I am single, yeah. Oh, no.
Have you got a question for the boys?
How do you perform on stage without getting nervous or anything?
Good question.
We don't get nervous about stage performing. We get nervous on radio or telly. But a room full of people who are there to see you, that's a good experience.
There you go. Brilliant, brilliant advice. We got loads of Darkness stuff to send you, Erin, in the post. Can we hear it for Erin? Weekend, 11 years old. And welcome to the show, The Darkness. It is lovely to see you, boys. What are you going to play for us first?
We'll play the one that Erin just did, but we won't do it as well as she.
You were never going to be as good as Erin, are you? Take it away, The Darkness on Radio 2.
Can't explain all the fears that you're making me feel. My heart's in overdrive and you're behind the steering wheel.
Rufus from the Darkness. Frankie's not here today. Frankie's having a lie-in.
Yeah. He is. We didn't raise him.
I know. He refuses to get up at such an hour. Yeah. In fact, he's probably just gone to bed. Knowing Frankie, it is so lovely to have you boys here. I'm having flashbacks, actually, to when I was at a different radio station, when you guys first started out work, and I was working with Matt Everett and Sean Keaveney over there, and following you guys around Camden and all sorts of places back in the early days. It's gone by in a flash, boys.
It certainly has.
I know.
We were thinking about those days as well.
Oh, my goodness. I know. There's some bits I remember. Some bits are a little bit vague. We were like your groupies.
If you can remember the early noughties, then you weren't there.
You weren't there. Exactly. That is exactly how it is. Congratulations on the album. Easter is cancelled. Came out in October. It's a marvellous thing. It's a thing of beauty. We've been loving In Another Life, which we've been playing a lot on Radio 2. You're back from a European tour. Played some amazing dates in the UK last year. Is life good for the Darkness at the moment?
Life is wonderful.
Yeah.
It's a great existence. We're touring all the time and we're making progress at last.
Yeah.
I think we're at a level now which is true to what we do, you know what I mean? Like, I think we had a moment when we were super, super popular, but perhaps it was a little bit hype-led.
Yes.
So now everything we do, we feel like we've earned it.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think it's quite an amazing, because you had this incredible sort of trajectory where you went from it, and then bang, boom, and everyone was following you.
Yeah, like the, what was it, the space shuttle, one of the space shuttles.
Yes.
We had a similar trajectory to one of the most recent of the space shuttles.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And then, yeah, straight up, and then just like a bit of scattering.
Okay.
And then,
basically, not the best analogy,
unpleasant moment in the sky.
Okay.
And then, but now we're getting ready for some more interplanetary explorations.
I love you, Justin. I really, really do.
I love you too.
There is something about the darkness, says Peggy in Wantage. We love Peggy. She says that always makes me smile and cheers me up. Thanks for doing what you're doing, guys. Thing is, though, it's kind of like all bands go on a little journey, don't you? And you can, you know, sometimes it comes too soon. Sometimes it takes a long time to get there. But whatever the journey, the fact is you're still here. And I think you're smashing it. And I think this album is your finest. It's brilliant. It's a concept album. Now, when people talk about concept albums, what does that mean, Justin, to the layperson like me?
I think for us it means that the body of work that is considered the album itself has to be consumed in one go, ideally, for you to really understand what we're trying to do with the music, you see. And then all the extra additional sort of superfluous tracks that become B-sides or bonus tracks or Japanese edition extra tracks and all the extra stuff you're supposed to do. There's no way that can be considered part of it because it's a narrative from track 1 to 10.
Yeah.
And there are a few threads that feed into ours, but it would be incredibly dull of me to go into those at this point.
Oh.
All I can say is you should listen to the new album by The Duck. This Easter is cancelled.
Thank you.
You'll see what I mean.
From beginning to end, first track, Rock and Roll Deserves to Die. I love the story behind that as well. It's a beautiful thing. Also, the video, you make amazing videos. You dress superbly. No one wears a cat suit like Justin. I have tried, and it just does not look quite the same. I think I had it on the wrong way round, to be honest with you. But you did the video for it in Another Life. There you are in a devil cat suit, which is just incredible. The boys are all in white suits. It's a beautiful thing. And there you have Abby Clancy as an angel.
She's been typecast with that. She is adorable on the inside and out. She's really hardworking as well.
Yeah.
People who look like that, I know it from my own experience. I am entitled to be a diva with these cheekbones. But she's like me. She's hardworking and she's humble as well. And it's just, it was a real pleasure to...
Patrick, you want to speak?
If I do have one... go on.
No, I've suddenly realised, just looking at you, if you cut your locks and got rid of the tash, there's a kind of a Peter Crouchness.
Oh, is that?
I think so. Is that why Abby said yes?
Oh.
I think she might have recognised some similarities.
Between the athletes. Yeah. You are both athletes, though. Yeah.
In a way.
Yeah. Where are we going with this?
I'm not sure.
We must talk about The Masked Singer as well. I mean, it's so weird. Jodie, did you watch The Masked Singer? Were you busy Doctor Who-ing?
I'm so sorry, I didn't.
No, don't worry. I think Justin said that's fine. He didn't watch it either. Patrick, did you get to see it? Were you over the other shores?
No, I wasn't. I was here and I was told that my wife was in it.
Right. Oh, well, yes, of course, Kat was one of the guests.
No, I was told that she was actually one of the singers.
Oh, really?
Somebody told me that.
How long did you think that Kat was in The Masked Singer, and which Masked Singer did you think she was?
Well, it was a floor manager. I have to be careful what I say here. So it was a floor manager who was actually on the show.
Mm.
And he said, is your missus in the show?
You were like, shouldn't you know, sir?
And at which point I'm thinking, what was she doing the last three Saturdays? And I think that was the joy of watching that show, was the fact that people kept the secret.
Yeah.
So there was, for a second, I thought, is she in it?
Yeah, Justin, who did you tell? Dan, did you know what your brother was up to?
Well, I mean, he was quite busy and unable to tell us what he was doing. So he kind of hinted, I'm doing a really big TV show that is big in the US, but this is the first time it's happening here. So
you knew.
I wasn't allowed to tell anybody. They told me I wouldn't get paid.
Oh, really?
Not that was, I mean, obviously the artistic merits of such an endeavour are self-evident, but...
It was such a moment, though, because that's the thing, is afterwards, when you see your face, you're like, of course it's Justin from The Darkness. I was infuriated, by the way. Rita Ora, she loved you, by the way, didn't
she? Until I took my mask off.
Yeah. We'll talk.
And then the affection transcended love.
Oh.
It became something more like a tolerance.
More from the darkness. Patrick Kilty and Jodie Whittaker on Radio 2. We must welcome to the show today our five-star Biz Quiz winner. We do a five-star Biz Quiz on a Thursday. Chris Tite from Hastings in Sussex.
Yeah.
He came on yesterday. He absolutely smashed it. He's brought his daughter Kelsey in with him today. Kelsey's 10. Kelsey, are you having a good time? Yeah, is it all right? Yeah. Dad's got you into rock and roll music. Sometimes. Some of it. Who's your favourite artist, Kelsey? Don't know. Don't put me on the spot, Zoe. Chris, I've just checked your T-shirt out, by the way. That's hilarious. This is Super Mario Brother with very little on. You've got a question for your idols, haven't you?
I have indeed. I saw you back in Brighton in 2004, and you appeared on stage in a really different way, which I can't mention on the radio. What's the most craziest idea have you had to open up a live show?
Well, we had one last time we played at Download. We did a thing where the band started and we started our song, which is called Barbarian, and it's all about the Viking invasion of, you know, East Anglia, and about the decapitation of King Edmund, hence Bury St. Edmund. It's all about that. So my stage entrance was surfing on some Viking shields from the back of the audience through to the thing. And everybody was inebriated and looking at me confused because, like, hang on a minute, it's supposed to be on the stage, but now it's behind me. What's happening? And it was amazing. Utterly amazing.
What we really want to happen one day is to fire Justin onto the stage via a cannon.
Yes, please, like Super Grover. Can we make that happen? There are human cannibals, aren't they? Surely.
The other one I've got is like an enormous bass drum. Yeah. And then Rufus does a big drum solo. And then at the end of a drum solo, you just hear a doorbell. And then a door opens on the bass drum and I come out and I've been in there. And then at the end of the show, get back in it.
Yeah, back in it. These are brilliant. Don't you love the minds of the darkness? I really do. You're going to play for us again. Chris, well done. Well asked. Kelsey, lovely to have you here. What are you going to play for us now, boys?
Love is only a feeling.
Okay, I love that. It's just like, we're just making this up. It's brilliant. The Darkness, live on Radio 2.
Oh, the first flush of youth was upon you when our eyes first met. And I knew that to you and into your life I had to get. Oh, I felt lightheaded in the touch of the stranger's hand. And I saw my defenses systematically fail to withstand. Cause you came at a time when I should have won true love.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Loving in the darkness, acoustic, it's stunning. So I was at Download. The Shield surfing was amazing, says Helen Check. That's just made my day. My husband and I walked down the aisle to the darkness 15 years ago. We love them. Joe from Dorset. Morning all, I saw the darkness in York just before Christmas. For anyone who has never seen them live, seriously, you are missing out. Justin in York. Well, get yourselves to the Download Festival on the 14th of June when you can see the boys playing live. And hopefully Justin will appear from a drum or be fired in a cannon. We're going to make that happen. Richie, the roads please, sir.
We'll start in West Lothian then, Zoe. On the M8 eastbound, we've got severe delays still between 3A for Bathgate and 2. It's because of that earlier broken down lorries. So everything's been reopened, but the queues are still well over an hour and they are crawling through there. In North Lanarkshire, the M74 Scott's been on to say southbound. There's two lanes blocked at the moment because ladders have fallen onto the road. So that's between 5 for the Wraith Interchange and 7 for Lark Hall. In Cumbria, the M6 North, there's a lane closed at the moment between 43 for Carlisle and 44. That's because there's a lorry having a tyre change. The M4 in Bridgend in Wales, the westbound side, there's a lane blocked between 35 and 36. That's because of an accident. Then eastbound, staying in Wales, the exit slip road is partially blocked at 48 for Llanelli, and that's because there's a bumper on the road. And Darren's been on, thank you. Darren's been on the A1M southbound. The exit slip road is partially blocked at 4 for Welling Garden City. That's because of a broken down car. I'll have more in half an hour.
Well, thank you very much, Richie. Get you and your pronunciation. We've got a big announcement on Monday's show. We can't say any more than that, but it's amazing. So, can you ask Justin, please, can he tell us about KT's Amazing Machines, the theme tune that they did for the CBeebies show, which we love. James from Cheltenham. How did this come about, Justin?
I think it's because we did another BBC thing, didn't we?
We did Zingzillas.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah.
And then, so we appeared on the Zingzillas Island in full costume. Right. And I think we've been on the CBBC radar since then.
Could you give us a little blast of the theme?
We'll do Gracie's, won't we?
Right, we'll do Gracie's. Yeah, brilliant. Go on, then. Here we go. CBeebies are absolutely thrilled. We've got two more songs to go and we've got more chat with Jodie Whittaker and Patrick Kilty. Don't go anywhere. It's on your people. Their latest album, Easter Is Cancelled. It's out now. If you don't have it already, then can you buy it, please? It's marvellous. But you have to listen to it from beginning to end like you do with proper albums. You can see them at Download Festival on Sunday the 14th of June and look out for, fingers crossed, more UK festival dates soon. I'm looking at the boys' eyes. Yeah, they're giving nothing away. Am I?
Are your fingers crossed? Everyone crosses their fingers and then our agent talks to some other people. You never know.
And you never know.
Or somebody might pull out.
Yes. There may be an injury. There's an injury for somebody.
Wouldn't it be a shame if one of these other bands had an accident?
Always a silver lining, Justin. By the way, can I just say, we have had so many messages in from mums and dads. Helen in deepest, darkest Norfolk said, my two-year-old Isla just did a Justin-style squeal in the car after hearing them doing Grace's Amazing Machines. My 3 and 4-year-old boys are huge fans. Please thank the darkness for the most epic theme tune to a kids' programmes that is nearly always lodged in my mind. Annalie from Newcastle. And thanks to the darkness for playing Grace's Amazing Machine theme tune. 2-year-old Isaac's favourite programme. He tries to sing along every time. Happy Friday to you all. That's Abby Boyle in Ipswich. Marvellous stuff. What are you going to play for us now, boys?
The one that we wrote about Abby Clancy.
Oh, the angel. She is an angel. I hope she's listening. You're right there, Abs. It is In Another Life, The Darkness, live on Radio 2.
Heart and soul,
Into Darkness on Radio 2 in another life. Current single from their latest album, Easter is Cancelled. Check the video out with Abby Clancy. So good. Lovely messaging. Hi, Zoe. I met the Darkness in December in Portsmouth. Only had my checkbook on me for autographs. Justin wrote himself a check for £1 million and left it there. Legend. That's from Graham Hernandez. Not been cashed yet then. No. Hi, Zoe and team. Our little six-year-old Alfie, obsessed with the Darkness. He plays his drums along with his favourites. Rock and Roll Deserves to Die and Heart Explodes every day. Wow, yes. Please, can you ask Justin and Rufus to do a shout-out to Alfie Manders and his brother, Jack Manders. Best regards from James and Jody. Will you give him a shout?
What are the names again? Alfie?
Yeah, Alfie and Jack.
Alfie and Jack.
Work.
Yes. Yeah. Except Rufus, we must welcome you because I know these boys from way back, but we have Rufus here, a drummer of the Darkness. Oh. How is life in the Darkness, Rufus?
Oh, it's amazing. I've been with these guys about six and a bit years now.
Oh, is he six and a bit years? Yeah, that is actually a long time. He's not a new boy at all, is he? No. Okay, I know. It's only because I haven't seen you, Steve. But you are from sort of rock, seriously strong rock heritage. People always mention to me about my dad. Do you mind if I mention to you about your dad?
No, that's all right.
Who is your dad, Rufus?
He's the drummer in a band called Queen.
Oh, yeah. Has anyone heard of Queen? '70s, yeah, Roger's your dad. I mean, that's it's amazing, isn't it? It's pretty amazing.
So hang on. Justin, yeah. Do you have a tattoo of his dad on your finger?
That was the first thing you said to me, actually.
That was the opening line.
Is it going to be weird for you having your dad's face tattooed on me?
Let's have a look at your dad's face on you. Oh, my goodness me. What amazing tattoos.
That was one of the first things I noticed whenever he came in this morning. And
I saw you staring, actually.
What's he looking at? That is quite weird.
In happier times, I had a wedding ring on there, and it looked like a little silver sort of headband.
Like a
sort of space age Beyond Borg.
There might be another one on there one day again.
Who knows?
Would you ever do it again?
When he marries Abby Clancy.
Depends who's asking, actually. Yes. Isn't it?
Peter's coming round and he's furious. I got to see Phil Collins playing. I think it was the sort of last year or year before, and his son, of course, plays drums in his band now. Have you played drums on stage with your dad ever?
Yeah, I actually did 5 years with Queen.
Yeah,
which was amazing.
My goodness me! That you're gonna learn your trade aren't you? That is absolutely fantastic.
That was the apprenticeship that
joined the Darkness. Yes, please. We're gonna have more music from the Darkness as well. So much love coming in from the Whovians. Jody, they're all asking what's going to happen for the Doctor in Series 13. But series, you don't know,
no,
do you?
I don't even need to be sneaky about that.
Yeah,
I don't know.
They don't tell you.
No, they don't tell me. Because I am a really good secret keeper, but sometimes it's just a little bit overwhelming when it's months in advance.
Okay.
So it's better. And I love the journey from episode to episode, reading it as well.
Okay.
There'll be conversations. They'll keep me a bit in the loop.
It's funny because we were asking Jodie if she'd seen The Masked Singer, and she hadn't seen The Masked Singer, but then we learnt out that her voice is on the little ad at the end of The Masked Singer. We're like, oh, yes! Because just... you paid for your first album, recording your first album, by making jingles for adverts.
I did, yeah.
Yeah!
There was one particular one that paid for Permission to Land. But it was a furniture company that hails from Sweden. So it's a flat pack album.
Oh, right. Very good. Very good. Good morning, these splendid fellows. Thank you to Justin and Dan and Rufus, and love to Frankie, of course. Their latest album, Easter is Cancelled, is out now. It makes me laugh every time I say that title. See them live at the Download Festival on Sunday, the 14th of June. Look out for more UK festivals too. Have a fantastic tour of New Zealand and Oz and the USA, finishing today with a marvellous piece of music. Justin, what can you tell us?
I can tell you that we've been delighted to be here. And we're going to spoil it all by murdering a Led Zeppelin song.
Yay! The Darkness on BBC Radio 2.
Drive our ships to new land, fight the whole.
To everyone for listening to the show this week. Thanks, Top Work from the Prod Squad. We're back on a Monday with Maximum Music Monday and a huge sport relief announcement. A member of the team is going to have a very exciting couple of weeks. Have a terrific weekend. Here's Ken Bruce.
I'm in
terrific weekend. Here's Ken Bruce.
I'm in
terrific weekend. Here's Ken Bruce.
I'm in
terrific weekend. Here's Ken Bruce.